Well, they finally got to the W's.
Fred is always excited, ready to go, ready to work.
He's not a boss, he's a leader. There's a huge difference between that. And it really inspires people to want to work more and to want to give more.
You knew he was your manager, but he also treated you like a friend and showed you respect.
He very much knows how to find good people and then takes care of them. That's one thing Fred does really well.
He's gonna come and ask you, you know, 50 times before the game. You know what I'm saying? Can I do anything? That's his favorite line. What can I do for you?
What can I do for you?
Anything I can help you with.
Is there anything I can do for you?
He treats the custodian like the CEO, and he treats the CEO like the custodian.
Here, Rick Malnati to my right.
Fred kind of built Game of the Week, working with Kenny and some of the other great on-camera talent and stuff. And the relationships he's built with the schools and stuff, I think this kind of goes back to just trying to tell great stories in an underserved community.
It's very important to Fred that we want to get out and show the community that Waggle Broadcasting cares.
This is where Fred really deserves the Silver Circle Award and is really truly a Chicago broadcaster. The way he has embraced these games, the Game of the Week and the high school sports that he's presented on the Weigel stations is a true community service.
Yeah, well, we really had some really good ones. We had Derrick Rose, Jahlil Okafor, Jabari Parker. I mean, those are three top NBA draft choices, and they're all National Player of the Year, all performing on Waggle Broadcasting on our Game of the Week.
Fred always made it about the kids and about the clients. That would probably be the greatest summary, and probably the goal of the company was not just to have a great game, but on a side note, he always picked the best games.
In and out, and nearly taken away. That's for the win. It's online. It's good. What a finish!
He has had such a passion for London. He was so excited when everything kind of went down for him to move there. The worldly fella, the pictures and the Facebook stuff and the blogging that he's done, it was just kind of the next step.
Worldly fellow, if you would. Do you have to stick your pinky out when you say that? Worldly fellow. It makes sense. Fred is a very educated guy. He is truly a worldly guy.
He really knows the history. So I think he wanted to take that history, and he had so much time to explore in London, that then what fun is it to have if you can't share it?
I like to think of Fred as something of a descendant of Edward R. Murrow, who famously broadcast from London during World War II and brought London home to Americans. And in so many ways, Fred is doing that himself as the worldly fellow. Through his writing, through his photography, through his broadcasts, he brings London and the British royal family back home to Chicago.
No, there's no slowing down. I think he wants to see everything.
If Fred had to move to the moon, I think he'd still find a way to do Game of the Week and make sure that this week's game is on the U2 Sports. It's one of the things that makes Fred great is nothing will stop him, no matter where he is, anywhere on this planet or any other one.
I can't see Fred ever stopping.
He has type A personality. He's not going to sit still for any time soon.
He's Chicago's royal watcher. Could he be Singapore's next thing? We don't know yet. He's only been there for a short time, but I wouldn't put it past him.
So, Fred, I know we couldn't get Barry here to present the award. However, in the words of the immortal Barry Manilow, it looks like we made it. Congratulations, Fred. Looks like